A very good evening to one and all. This is Deepak Sharma and I'm gonna teach you the electrical machines. And today, after finishing our previous unit, which was the induction machines, the single phase and three phase induction machines we talked in our previous units, in our current unit we'll talk about the synchronous machines. Okay, so before coming on synchronous machines, we have to understand what does it mean, the synchronous. The synchronous is basically when something, the word mean is when something is happening together, something is happening synchronously. Like in induction machines also, we had a speed, the synchronous speed, which was 120 F upon P, which was generated due to that simple derivation of calculating the number of rotation in particular time period in a minute. When it is divided by 60 seconds, it will come out with 120 f by p, the synchronous speed formula. And we are very much clear about the synchronous speed, which is generated by the rotating magnetic field of the stator. The stator has a balanced three-phase star or delta connected supply and windings on it, which will generate a natural rotating magnetic field, which was studied in the previous units. Due to that synchronous speed, due to that RMF, the rotor feels a torque which will try to move it in some direction. And in case of induction machines, the direction of rotation will be in the same direction of the synchronous speed. We studied about the Lenz law and those things, that due to the mutual induction principle, the rotor will try to oppose, the direction of rotor will be such that it will try to oppose the cause of it. So the rotor will rotate in the same direction of the synchronous speed. Now, in the case of synchronous machines, the rotor will always rotate in the direction of the magnetic field. In case of induction motors, induction machines, we had both sides supplied with the AC supply. Like your stator, which had the field windings, it was supplied through single phase or three phase AC supplies. And the EMF, the current on rotor, was generated by the mutual induction between the stator and rotor windings. But in the case of synchronous machines, one side, either your rotor or stator, will have a DC supply, or directly I can say the excitation generated in the case of synchronous generator, which is called alternator, will be DC supply directly. So what happens in the case of synchronous generator, this in the synchronous machines or the synchronous motors, the synchronous motor will always rotate on the synchronous speed, otherwise it will not rotate. Irrespective of asynchronous machines, the asynchronous machine, the induction machines, sets themselves at a different torque according to the load. As load increases, the speed decreases. And as the speed decreases, mutual induction, the flux cutting increases. Due to that increment in flux cutting, rotor will try to generate more EMF and will set itself at a new speed. And that speed will always remain lesser than the synchronous speed. But in the case of synchronous generator or the synchronous motor, either rotor will rotate, or it will rotate on the speed of synchronous speed, the 120 FIP, or it will never rotate. Okay. So if you will increase the load on the synchronous motor, it will bear that load, but when it will become intolerable to it, it will pull out of it and will stop. So the difference between synchronous speed and the synchronous machine and the asynchronous machine, the synchronous machines always run at a constant speed. So with this theory, we'll start on this unit, and in this unit and in this presentation we'll go through these contents. Firstly, apart from the syllabus, I have included the a slide with the RTU syllabus and the introduction of synchronous machines, and a brief will be given for the synchronous machine. Next, the constructional features, cylindrical rotor, the type of rotors, the generator DMF, the equivalent circuits and the phase diagrams, the armature reaction, the synchronous impedances, the voltage regulation, operating characteristics of synchronous machine, V-curves, silent pole machines, the two reaction theory, the analysis of phase diagram, the power angle characteristics and the parallel operation of the alternators. This is the RT syllabus, which we had in our previous slide also. So, as an introduction, we are starting here the synchronous machines. The synchronous machines constitute of both synchronous motors as well the synchronous generator. Okay. An AC system has some advantage over the DC system. Therefore, the AC system is exclusively used for the generation, transmission and distribution of electricity. Basically, in our current system, in our conventional system, we do use the alternators of the synchronous generators for the generation of supply, because the synchronous generators works on the synchronous speed or the constant speed drives, and to generate the AC supply, it is very much more beneficial than the asynchronous machines. Okay, the definition of AC machine will be, the synchronous machines will be the machines which convert mechanical power into AC electrical power is called synchronous generator or an alternator. However, if the same machine can be operated as a motor, known as a synchronous motor. So it is the best, it is a very common principle of electromechanical energy conversion, that the device which will convert electrical to mechanical, which will be your generator, and the device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy will be your motor. In the case of synchronous machines, the synchronous generator is also called alternator because it generates the AC supply for you. Basically, we do use three phase generators only in our system, in our current system, because the single phase supply can be taken out from any of its phases. So it will be more economical to generate three phase supply instead of using a single phase generators of 3 amp, because the single phase supply will always be available from those three phases generated by the alternators. Okay. A synchronous machine is an AC machine whose satisfactory operation depends upon the maintenance of the following relationship, where the NS, which is your synchronous speed, will be 120 FIP. Okay, this NS will be generated by the three-phase supply, which is supplied to the three-phase star or delta connected winding, as we had in the induction motors also, which will generate a balanced three-phase rotating magnetic field, and this will always remain constant. It will be constant because 120 is a constant numeric number, and F will be the frequency which is coming from the supplied side. As standard, we have 50 hertz, so it will be constant. And number of poles, once you have designed your machine, your number of poles are fixed, so your synchronous speed will always remain constant. The synchronous speed will be generated by the field, the three-phase field of applied on the static part of your stator. Okay. Where your f is pns upon 120. Okay. From this formula, the ns is the synchronous speed in revolution per minute, the rpm, f will be the frequency in hertz or cycles per second, p will be the number of poles. So we are clear that the synchronous motors will also have the synchronous speed generated by the three phase winding. And in the case of generator, the speed provided by the prime mover to your armature must be this. Because in the case of generator, we will give some mechanical power to it, and that mechanical power will have the speed. This is the synchronous speed, which has frequency and number of poles. Okay. When connected to an electrical power system, a synchronous machine always maintains the above relationship shown in the equation. The synchronous machine maintains this relationship of synchronous. If the synchronous machine working as a motor fails to maintain the average speed ns, the machine will not develop sufficient torque to maintain its operation and will stop. Then the motor is said to be pulled out of step. As we discussed earlier, the synchronous machine will run at a synchronous speed only, irrespective of its load. The synchronous machine will always run at synchronous speed. Otherwise, if you will increase the load further and it goes to unbearable limits, the synchronous motor will lose its synchronism and it will be pulled out of step. That is called pull out torque. The torque at that time will be the pull out torque. In case when the synchronous machine is operating as a generator, it has to run at a fixed speed called synchronous speed to generate the power at a particular frequency. As all the appliances of machines are designed to operate at this frequency, in some countries the value of frequency is 50 hertz. As in India, if we will talk about India, we have a standard 50 hertz frequency level. So all the generators which are connected to the national grid are generating the same standard frequency of 50 hertz, and the same frequency is being delivered to the all type of loads, the households, the industries, agricultures, which are all machines works on 50 hertz frequency. We have designed the system. Okay, coming on next, the basic principle of a synchronous machine. A synchronous machine is just an electromechanical transducer. It works as a transducer. We can call it a transducer, which is converting a form of energy into another form, which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy and vice versa. The fundamental phenomena or law which makes this conversation possible are known as law of electromagnetic induction and law of interaction. So basically, when we talk about principles for any motor or for any machines, as we have discussed it so many times, that the mechanical energy will be converted into electrical energy and electrical will be into mechanical energy, it generates motor or generator. Apart from that, a motor, for a general motor, the principle will be followed as whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will feel a force which will rotate it in some direction. When we talk about generators, a common principle which will be applied on all type of generators, that will be whenever a conductor is moving in a magnetic field, it will cut that magnetic field and it will feel some EMF in it and will give you output EMF across the conductors. This will be the construction. Before coming on detailed principle of a synchronous motor or generator specifically, we'll talk about the construction feature of a basic synchronous